Hello, so today we're going to be looking at lab number 2 on the wiki.dot website for Microchip, and we'll be modifying it slightly because we're using the PIC32 boards like this or like this in the EECS 2121 class. So if we scroll over here, we'll see that we are at the wiki.dot site, lab number 2. You will have already downloaded MPLAB X as well as the XC32 compiler. And I've started up a new project. This one is for lab 2, and it's very similar to the code for lab 1. And the big difference here is that I've added in a global counter variable, and I define it right here as, actually, I'm going to move that from there to right there. So it's int global CTR is equal to 0. So a global variable that is a counter and is equal to 0 initially. Save that. And inside of my while loop, the same while loop that I had in lab 1, inside of the while loop, I have incremented it at the bottom of the while loop. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to compile. That and everything seems to be working out just fine. And I'm going to go back over to the wiki.dot site and see that the code is similar. I want to select simulator as the hardware tool. So to do that, I can right click on lab02, go to properties. It's hard, you can't actually see it in the window right now, to the bottom of this window. Or contextual menu. Here it is. I've chosen simulator and XC32. I say OK. Let's go back over to wiki.dot. Selected the simulator. I need to change options. So the wiki.dot site shows you that if you select tools from the top menu in Windows, you'll be able to get this options submenu. On the Mac, it's a little bit different. You go to MPLAB X here, you go to Preferences, and you end up getting the same option menu. Okay, so we want to select Embedded and Generic Settings, Embedded and Generic Settings, and we want Debug Startup to halt at main. So I go Debug Startup here, and halt at main. Then I click on OK. So now we're set to simulate the code in the computer. So rather than run it on a board like this, we're going to run it as a simulation within the Mac or PC that we're using. And what we're going to do is run the Debug Project feature. So I'm going to switch over to MPLAB X like this. I click on this 123 with a little green triangle on it. It says debug main project, like that. Now, I'd set it to stop at the main function, and here we go. It has done exactly that. It says the user program has stopped, and it stopped at line 62, highlighted in green, main function right there. We can see that we have a debug toolbar that shows up. Let's switch over to that. And you can see the debug toolbar right there. If your window is too small, then the additional icons, like these right here, show up as a vertical option. Let me just move that out a little bit so you can see it better. Like this. Okay. So what we need to do is step into. So run your cursor over here. You can see that we have step over. Step into, and it steps into and lands on latch A. Latch A initially has a value of 1111, like this. And what we want to do is we want to run to cursor right here. So I'm going to set up my cursor to be on line 74. latch A is equal to 0x0001. It's a little bit different than what you see in the wiki.site. I won't explain why, but it's a little bit different, the value that's being assigned. I'm now going to say run to cursor, which is this icon right here. And what ends up happening is at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the lab to build, load, and the candy bar right there. And then it says debugger halted. So it's now halted at line 74. There's a little green arrow right here, and it says latch A0x0001. If I hover over lat A or latch A, it says that all the values have now been changed to zeros in that particular memory register. Okay, what are we doing next? We go back over to the wiki.site, and it says hover over the latch A. Then what we want to do is step into to go to the delay function. And now we're on to step 6, breakpoints. So breakpoints are a very common thing that we do. Excuse me. It's set up right here. So I put a breakpoint right here by clicking on the number of the line, and it puts a pink square right here and then highlights in pink the entire row. So at this point, I can hit continue and the program will break at that particular line of code. So I click continue, and then it says lab02 build load, and the candy bar progress meter goes on like this. It's currently simulating. Then it halts, and you'll see that the green arrow is superimposed on the pink square, which means it is halted at the breakpoint. If I put my cursor over lat A, we'll see that the latch A or lat A register has been changed in value from a bunch of zeros before to a bunch of zeros with a 1. And the 1 corresponds to bit 0 of latch A. And you'll see that that value has been changed to red to indicate that it has recently been changed. If I go back over to the wiki.site, then it says try a step over. So we're now in a break point. I want to step over. And let me see, step over would be right here. Step over allows me to go to the next line of code, global CTR. This is a counter that is going to be incremented. We can see that currently it has a value of 0. If I do step over again, I did it twice. We've gone through the while loop and we're back up to the top of the while loop. If I hover over global CTR, we'll see that its value has been changed to 1 from 0. So we've done step over. We've got these continue commands and breakpoints. If I hit continue a bunch of times, what we'll see is the simulator will kick in and we will break on the breakpoint once the simulator is done simulating. And then every time I do that, the latch A value will change, it will toggle, and the global counter value also will change every time it runs through this cycle like this. Okay, so I'm going to click again. And we wait, and you can get your coffee, and if you've got a really slow computer, it will take even more time. If the program becomes really complicated, this can take a long time to do. Global CTR has been changed to a value of 2. Latch A has got a value of 1. If I put a breakpoint here and run it again, we'll see that the next time it increments over and continues to this breakpoint, latch A will be set to 0 because it will stop just before lat A is equal to 0x0001 is executed. Let's take a look at its value. Yes, it's equal to 0. It means that this particular assignment hasn't been executed yet. Okay, so we can do that many, many times. The next thing we want to do is see how we can set up a watch window. So while it's really useful to hover over particular variables in your code one line at a time, that's good for debugging. Sometimes you want to have something a little bit more organized. And so what we do is we go over to Window, Debugging, Watches, and then we right-click down in here in this Watches tab. I go right-click, New Watch. I'm going to set up a special function register watch. So I'm going to scroll down to where it says lat a or latch a. Be really careful. It should be in here somewhere. There we go. We hit OK. So there we have it. And I'm going to right click again and I'm going to say new watch, and I want to have that global variable as well. So global symbols, global CTR, like this. And we can see that currently the global CTR is equal to 3, latch A is equal to 0. I'm going to hit continue. And then every time I hit the continue, it will go to one of the breakpoints and we'll see that the value of the watched variable or watched memory location or watched special function register will change. So here we can see that lat A changed to a value of 1. I'll click on this again. There we go. The global CTR has changed to 4 and latch A has been set to 0. We can do it again and we'll see that latch A will be set to 1. And watch the value of the PC right here, the program counter. It changed to 9D000128, as well as the change to the latch A variable. Let's do it again. Program counter value will change. This is the location in memory of the code. And these are the values of the variables and registers that we're modifying. So global counter has changed to value of 5, latch A is now 0, and your program counter has changed to a different address. And we can do this ad infinitum. Okay, we can do this a lot over and over and over again. But this is basically how you do debugging in simulation in MPLAB X. When you're done with the simulation, you click on Finish Debugger Session, or this pink box up here at the top. And there you have it. This is lab number 2.